All right, here we are some more.
It's good cold outside. Summertime isn't quite yet summer yet. We still got to get to the 4th of July. Should be coming up soon. What time is it? Let's see when the 4th of July is. Let's check the calendar. Sunday. Today's the 30th, so Sunday is the 4th of July. Alright. Well, it usually takes about the end of the July to get hot out anyway, so. That way we can stay out there till like about midnight and stuff like that. Making 50 vids a day on the teachings of Yeshua. Which is fine with me, because this way I'll have a historical account on vid, man. Reference points. Anyway, we're still in Matthew chapter 5. Matthew chapter 5. And we were going through the Beatitudes, you know. So we have an idea what the Beatitudes are all about. These Beatitudes are sarcasm. One thing is said, another is intended. When Yeshua says, "Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God, see the Most High," what he means is, blessed are the perfect. Or what he means is, blessed are the pure in heart, but nobody can be pure. Nobody. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of the Most High. Peacemaker that the Most High requires. Nobody. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sakes, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. In other words, theirs is the kingdom of law. Who can be perfectly persecuted for righteousness' sake? Nobody. There is one who can do it. One who did do it. There is one who did do it. His name happened to be Yeshua. He was the son of Elohim, Yahweh, the Most High. Yeshua was the Most High in a man's body. Thus, Yahweh the Most High came down in a man's body and stood in our stead as a man and performed all of his commands, the very commands that we failed at, the very commands that Satan failed at. So, the Most High himself came down and saved us all. As only the Most High could do. Because he is the Most High. He is all superior. He is our creator. And we are just his creation. And there's no way we can be like him. No way. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for your great For great is your reward in heaven, for so persecuted they the prophets which were before you.
He's still being sarcastic. He's still talking about someone that can be perfect. Even though the prophets couldn't be perfect either, he's just throwing in the prophets as an example of persecution. Yeah, they were persecuted too. Anybody can be persecuted. Even the prophets were persecuted, man. How much more would you be anyway? You ain't even a prophet. Prophets were right out in the open. They were easy to be persecuted. You knew who the prophets were, man. They came right before the king and said, "Yo, you're messing up, dude." Well, everybody knew who the prophets were. They're easily persecuted. Blessed are you, a piddly unknown. Blessed are you who just happen to be a piddly unknown. Blessed are you to get persecuted. Blessed are you. If you could be perfect, piddly unknown. You see Yeshua's sarcasm, man? Yeshua has a sense of humor, man. We were created in his image. Humor is part of our Maker's image. The Most High has a sense of humor. Are we starting to see the picture? Are we starting to see where the parables of Yeshua line right up and they mesh and they weave right together with knowledge of the sin? It's all the same thing. So now we have to wipe away all the thick mud that's been put over our eyes by our leaders. Just like we've had to wipe away all the thick mud with this the straw man illusion that we've been living all of our lives. Now let's go down a little deeper in the rabbit hole and start wiping off the mud from the gospel illusion that we've been told. Like I said, I'm gonna take us to the deeper parts of the rabbit hole now. Now that we've hit rock bottom, we're gonna find all the holes that have been plugged up that go even deeper. Matthew chapter 5, verse 13. Ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt have lost his savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is henceforth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men. Ye are the salt of the earth. But if the salt has lost its flavor, the salt has lost its flavor, man.